Chimpaka's Musicals, the musical, this 2011, we decided to do something different from the production. Usually for our box office productions, we will do a music video where we get the whole cast and crew to be involved. But I think for this year, we wanted to do something a bit special. So we decided to do what is called the lip dub in reverse, which is a combination of two challenging skills. One is shooting a lip dub, which is a continuous shot from start to finish. Once you see the video, you'll notice that there were no cuts in between. The shot was actually a continuous shot. And also it was done in reverse so that you get some interesting effects that we have been working on for the past 2 to 3 weeks. In doing the lip dub, preparation was key, because we did realize that a lot of the effects that were taken could only be done once or took a long time to reset. Therefore, it was important to make sure that every second was mapped out. Over here, we actually did a lot of work in preparation. We created stations for the pool, for the gallery, for the ramp, and the hall in which you see the video. So for example, in this case, I put people like Imran and Yvonne in charge of the pool. The ramp had Isaac, Adila, and so on and so forth, which basically meant that different mini producers would have to figure out what they wanted to do in their stations, in their areas, so that when we combine it together, you get one seamless video. Special note to two extreme packers to join us for the lip dub, which would be Vince Chong and Brian Lui as well. They were instrumental in planning this. Planning took about 2 to 3 weeks, in which we had to meticulously prepare the instruments which would be thrown at the camera, get the hula hoops ready, fold the paper planes, blow balloons, water balloons, and this is what the production team, the broadcast production team in Suzical had to prepare. A lot of work went behind the scenes in terms of making sure that everyone had the right equipment, they knew when to throw it, and basically making sure that we had the bigger picture in mind before we actually shot the music video itself. The key to shooting in reverse, obviously, is being able to sync backwards. So beforehand, we actually had to play the music backwards and start typing out the lyrics phonetically rather than just reversing the letters. And it was quite tricky for our lead singers, as you will see. They had to sing phonetically backwards so that when we reversed the clip, it looked like they were singing forward. And they had to walk backwards in the clip so that it looked as though they were walking towards the camera to lend that illusion. In shooting it as well, you would probably see in the making of later on that the shooting team was basically comprised of Brian Lui and Laiket on the camera, and I would be behind giving cues as to when the effects should take place, which is really important to catch most of the effects. We even had a mini compo focus all the way around in order for us to capture the timing of the song. It was interesting to actually note that everyone had to actually pretend as though they had the song in forward rather than in reverse. There were many stations involved in the making of this production, so you could see that the team had to get together. We even actually stayed back till like 2 in the morning to make sure we planned the path of the actual route that the camera would take. That one, each second had to be accounted for. So we knew at which section whether we had to move faster or slower. In fact, then each of the mini producers themselves had to decide as to what they were going to do. Am I going to get people to jump off? Am I going to get throw things at the camera? Would we have water balloons, hula hoops? All this had to be choreographed. Chefar was also instrumental in making sure that the different stations work together in order to get it to work seamlessly with the dancers as well, with the lead singers going through the effects, and at each station the singers would actually introduce the effect that we wanted to create for that particular part of the video. In the end of the day, we had to do a few dry runs first, which actually halted the production for about a day and a half, when we went through the whole thing again and again to make sure we got it right. That was also very important to get the finished product, but I think you will agree that the final product was worth the effort, and it was a great amount of fun, and it was a challenge that the whole production team as well as the cast and crew took to heart and did really well. I would like to thank the production team, the broadcast team, for their hard work and their dedication, as well as the cast and crew and CPAC for their support. I hope you liked the video.
me.
Shoot!